making his way to the ring now, and he looks very focused for this fight. Minutes still ahead of him here, round one of 12. Oh, a nice two-punch combo by Crusher. Crusher's left, working well that time. Covers up nicely, gets rid of his opponent's body shot. But he came back with a right hand of his own. Scored well up top. Chavez is smashed by an uppercut. Ooh. And coming upon the halfway mark of this 3-minute round. Oh, and he returns fire with a left hand.
Get inside, get inside.
Headshot lands, was a hook. Targeting a left hand to the body. Blocks that punch. Chavez is putting forth that hard work he did in training camp there, landing a crisp combination. See him trying to cut down that tree with a well-placed right hand.
You got this one.
A solid uppercut by Macho. Well-targeted 1-2 by Macho. Final 10 seconds. And we come to the end. Here we go. Round 2 is underway. He got hit, but he sends it right back. And now he's targeting upstairs.
Stay focused on the inside.
What impact from that uppercut by Macho. And now he brings the left hand upstairs. He missed that uppercut. Comes across with a hook up top.
He clearly came in with a strategy here tonight, Teddy, and so many times it's, hey, I'm going to bang that drum.
Yeah, he is banging that drum. That drum happens to be the body, and he figures that he's going to try to move on him, so start doing it early on, and later on, he's going to have a guy in front of him.
90 seconds to go here in this round. Sets up that right hand with the jab. Crusher's making for a tough target there. He gets away from that punch. He got hit right there, but he also gave one. Solid effort by Chavez. Macho's almost looking foolish that time he missed so badly.
In and out! In and out!
Just 10 seconds to go here in the second round. And now we got a fight. He fires back a right hand of his own. Chavez is missing punches.
Guess what? They don't find the mark. They're not accurate.
flush with the two-punch combo by Macho.
Work the body, kid. Body shots. Back to the body.
See, that's the work they want to see with the right hand by Crusher. Good flush shot upstairs. Commits to the straight right. That's a forceful two-punch combo by Crusher. Halfway through this round. Targeting a left hand down low. Nice defense. Good block by Crusher. That's a nice combination right there. Left hook, and then finished it with a right uppercut. Accurate shot, straight right hand comes in. Dismisses his opponent's headshot. Takes one, gives one. The right hand scores well. Little head hunting with the left.
Uppercut!
Last 10 seconds of round number three. Gets rid of that. It was intended for his head. Crusher's enjoying a lead on Teddy's scorecard the first time we look at the scores ringside here tonight. Although, early on here, it's not as if either man is in complete control of this fight. Chavez's defense is now serving him well. Nice job blocking that punch. Off to the side, a little swing and a miss going upstairs. Chavez is getting back to basics, a good solid jab.
Close the jab.
What a great job. He gave one right back in return. Nice work by Macho. Keeps his hands up defensively, protecting the head. Jab and a straight right by Macho. Able to get away from that headshot with the block. The last thing either guy wants to be here, Teddy, is one-dimensional.
The last thing you want to be in anything to be successful is one-dimensional. I mean, if you're a comedian, you don't want to be saying the same jokes all the time. Your crowd's not going to be there. Well, your opponent is going to be there all night long if you do the same thing.
Nice, crisp 1-2 combination by Crusher. Crusher's doing good damage with the combination punching.
Well, right there's a good example of the benefit of combination punching. You miss the first or the second, the third and the fourth, they land.
Solid uppercut.
Back to the body.
A couple of quick jabs landed by Macho. Fourth round now with its last 10 seconds. Right hand over the top, very accurate with it. Back underway here to live fight action. Tough fight to score. Very, very even, closely contested bout throughout. Comes right back with some offense of his own. How about that left hand? Chavez is so dangerous with that accuracy, a two-punch combination landing. Not able to connect with the uppercut. Good return fire that time. A stinging uppercut by Macho. Do you see any way in which he can take his opponent's aggression and turn it against him?
Yeah, the perfect way. I mean, boxing 101, counterpunching. You got a guy coming at you, no better way than to change his mind. Make him miss, make him pay.
Macho's way off the mark. That punch didn't have a chance. Crusher's the kind of boxer that... Look at that! Chavez has got to get up here. He was just knocked down. Now he's got a soldier on. He went down from a big shot. Now he's got to have some big guts to move along.
You're going to find out exactly what he's made of.
Chavez's jab can do so much there. He used it well that time. Final 10 seconds of this fifth round.
Relax, relax.
Macho's got a good relationship with his corner, but now it needs to pay off. He was down in that last round. They need to get to work. Good scoring shot. It was a straight right. Chavez is doing well here with that two-punch combination. Protecting his head well with his guard.
Let's see some more head movement.
Macho's doing a poor job here. This is not how he wants this fight to be. He wants to be winning this fight as an inside fighter. That's not how it's playing out.
Yeah, he needs to be on the inside. But you know what? Maybe he doesn't want to be there. Because there's nothing else that's stopping him from going there. Maybe he doesn't have the confidence, the wherewithal, the discipline to get there.
Committing to the work downstairs with the left. Reaching the halfway point of round number six. Look at that combination by Crusher. Just one jab. He throws that second one right behind it. There's a straight right hand.
Move in, move in.
Basic but beautiful jab right hand. Final 10 seconds of the sixth round. This has been a very... I would really be surprised if we go to a decision here. It just has that kind of feel to it.
Yeah, it has a feel to me like going to one of those places where you can eat all the pasta you can for one price, you know? And some guys get carried away. They eat about five bowls. Well, these guys, they're going to have a stomachache at the end. Somebody is going to wind up not standing at the end.
That's the clean shot with the left hand that he was looking for by Macho. And oh, what a good strong uppercut by Macho. Crusher's impressing the judges and himself with that right hand. Here's a moment here as you see the step back counterpunch where you realize this is the sweet science, not just some raw savagery swinging out there.
Look at the little subtleties here, Joe. What he does is he forces them into a position to stop the punch. And then when he stops, steps back, makes a miss, and comes right back.
Chavez is just punching air that time. His opponent was able to get out of the way. I gotta stop and make this statement at this point in the fight. This may be, combined, one of the most amazing performances I have ever seen. How are they able to keep up this pace?
Something way, way down inside, and it's beautiful to watch.
To the head he goes with a left hand. Well-placed counterpunch by Crusher.
Coming towards the end of the seventh round, 10 seconds to go. And round seven.
I'm always interested in how a fighter's disposition can change during the course of a fight. And as we start round number eight here, you see that he is up. But all it takes is a little momentum to build against him, and this thing could turn around.
Well, the real testing of a fighter, the real testing of a professional is what they can do late. Can they keep it up, or do they become satisfied? We're going to find out right now how this guy is in those areas.
Fires right back at him. Back and forth exchange. Macho's showing you that sublime skill right now with that two-punch combo. Blocks the headshot. Took a shot, now he gives a left. The halfway point of round number eight. Macho's work in training camp is now paying off. Do you see the accuracy and the effectiveness with that combination? Well, he missed that right. Staying away from those headshots with his defense up top. Rusher's landing a combination here. That's what he does when he's at his very best. A well-placed left hand up top. Chavez is doing what every trainer wants to see their fighter do. Land punches in bunches. The combination lands. What an impact that left hand just made by Macho. Rusher's been able to avoid having any of his opponent's headshots landing flush.
And what his opponent has to do, Joe, is make an adjustment. What we used to tell the fighters, when a guy's elusive, like this fighter is space to travel, they have a better chance of getting to that elusive target.
Chavez's movement's really helping him out, avoiding that punch. What a hook to the body by Macho. Well-targeted two-punch combo by Crusher. Macho scoring with that right hand. See how he targets that hook? Turns over that hook upstairs. Solid hook upstairs. Oh, and he's got something for him himself, and it's a left hand. Good flush shot by Macho.
That's it.
Pulls the trigger right away with the left hand after getting tagged himself. Macho's combination punching is working well here. He just missed that shot up top. 90 seconds into the ninth round. Comes right back at him with a left hand. Fighting. That's a crushing right hand by Macho. Crusher's legs can't fail him now. Oh, my. What a big shot. Teddy, he goes down, and he was on the outside where he doesn't like to be.
Where he shouldn't be, and he paid a price.
Down he goes. Now up he gets.
And if he wants to stay up, he's going to have to grab on, kill a little time.
Scores with the uppercut. And now he's acting like a fighter, coming back with the right hand after getting short upon. Chavez is putting his punches together now. That's a nice combination.
Come on, get focused.
End of the round. Calm a guy down after he scored a knockdown.
That's a really great point, because a lot of times that can be the turning point, but not for your guy that scored the knockdown, for the other guy. Because sometimes when you score a knockdown, you start to think it's going to be an easy night. And you forget what you knew when you came in, that it wasn't going to be an easy night. You're going to have to bring all the tools out of the tool shed. And it's important to remember that.
Rusher's just not showing me enough offense right now. I understand he did get hurt earlier.
Yeah, he did.
But he still has to put something forth.
Yeah, it does. It's kind of like that kid who gets his hand caught in a cookie jar. You know, you're not going to give up eating cookies. You still have a sweet tooth. You want to still go back and get that snack. You better find another way. He needs to find another way.
Got this one.
Here's one for you now, he says. Right back with the left hand. Body shot lands. It was the right. Double jab by Macho. Halfway through round 10. Well-timed by Crusher. He took a step back, landed the counterpunch.
Exactly what he wanted to do.
He's committed to that left hand, and it's working out. Counting down towards the end of the 10th round, 10 seconds to go. Crusher's defense, is it ever good? Look at how easy he's able to block those punches. Round number 11. Teddy, this has been a very good fight. Your scorecard has it even. Chavez's corner is trying to implore him to go out there and just give a little more. Make that difference. Get that win.
Well, that's what it comes down to. Who can do the little extra thing? You know, if the other guy throws two, you throw three. The other guy throws three, you throw four. That's how you win a close fight down the stretch.
Looks to the head. Macho's combination punching is just perfect there. Three punches landing. Good clean shot, returning fire. Well done by Chavez. Crusher's defense is paying off now. Unable to score with the hook.
Get inside, get inside.
He comes back with the left hand again. Nice strike after catching one by Chavez. Right hand downstairs. Good defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault. Final minute of this round that has been nothing but two straight minutes of non-stop fury.
Fasten your seatbelt. More turbulence ahead.
Well, he goes to the gut with a right hand. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. Chavez is putting forth that hard work he did in training camp there, landing a crisp combination. Right to the head with that right. Last 10 seconds of this 11th round. A headshot blocked. Macho's in position. Don't worry about the fact that it's a close fight. Go out there and win it here in these later stages. And now he scores well with a straight right. Crusher's so dangerous with that accuracy. A two-punch combination landing. Takes one but gives one. Good work by Macho. That's a razor-sharp uppercut by Chavez. Macho's on the receiving end of a very good counterpunch. Well-targeted combination by Crusher. That's great stuff. He fires one right back after taking one. Gotta love the work by Macho. He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left-hand scores. Crusher's tag. Halfway through this 12th and final round. Good double jab by Crusher. Chavez is not having things go his way tonight, but there's one easy explanation for it. He's barely moving. He's just stationary there.
And his opponent's taking great advantage of that. He's coming in, he's finding him, he's giving him angles. You know, I think part of it is frustration. He's not moving because he's being kept off balance, and right now he's just not thinking right.
Jump on. Nice.
Scores up top with a left. Chavez has put forth a little boom, 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 a three-punch combination scoring. A clean, crisp right hand by Macho. Seconds to go in this, the final round. Right hand, left hook to the body. Final bell of a fight fan's fight here, but also the kind of fight that you know there's going to be controversy over the score.